بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
To add to make a task easy and finish it with a good ending. ربي يسر ولا تؤسر وتمم بالخير.
Assalamu alaikum class, it's me Ms. Kanis Fatma from the Educator Faruk Class Campus. In class 8, today we are going to learn the science. You know that, as usual, when we start our class, first we recite the dua. So recite dua with me. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, bismillah ar-rahman ar-rahim. Rabbi yassir wa la tu'assir wa tammim bil khair. Ameen, summa ameen. Class 8. Today we are going to learn the chapter number 3, synthetic fibers and plastic. The synthetic fiber we have learned before, so our today's topic is the plastic. Plus, what is the plastic? Plastic is a polymer. Plastic is a polymer and plastic have two types of the arrangement. First is the linear. And second one is the crossed-like. It's plastic arranged in two types. Plus, the question is that from where we get the plastic? We get the plastic from crude oil. We know that the crude oil is changed into the fuel, but the remaining part of the crude oil is converted into the plastic. So we get the plastic from the crude oil. Now class, the why the so many things is made by the plastic? Because of these qualities. First one is the non-reactive. Plastic is not react with air, water. That's why we made the thing with the plastic. And the second one, plastic is light and very much strong. Plastic is very lightweight and it is very strong, and we can mold them into the any shape. It's easily change their shape. That's why we make the things also from the plastic, and plastic is also very much strong. And third one is poor conductor. Plastic is very poor conductor, and plastic is, you can say that it is the insulator, and plastic don't allow to pass the electric current in it. For this quality, we make the electric wire covered with the plastic. And the last one is the chemical reactivity. The plastic is not react with the acid and alkali. So we made the plastic bottles and so many things because it's chemically is not the very much reactive. Now class, what happened when the plastic is hit? When the plastic is heated, it becomes the thermoplastic and it's easily softened. And we can mold into the any shape. And it's remold, we can remold again and again. So thermoplastic is very useful. Now the next one is the thermosetting of the plastic. The thermosetting of the plastic, it's do not soften, is not soften when we provide them heat. So it cannot remold.
Now class, I'm giving you the homework. You open the page number 43 and here the activity C. Pretend yourself to be plastic and answer the following question. What does it mean? You have to consider yourself as a plastic and you have to give the answer. What type of the fibers are you? We have discussed about these things. Natural or the synthetic. Name the sum of your useful properties. If you are the natural or if you are the synthetic, you have to give the useful properties. And what are the two groups into which you can be classified? Just like I have told you, then the classification of the is the synthetic plastic or the thermostatic plastic. Number 4. Which properties of your is used to the use for the above classification? And which plus qualities or the properties you have to classify by yourself? And are you biodegradable or non-biodegradable? What is the biodegradable? The thing which can easily mix with the soil. These are the biodegradable, and which cannot mix into the soil. These are called the non-biodegradable. So what are you, biodegradable or non-biodegradable? Number 6, how can you be safely disposed? And how can you be safely disposed of? You know that it is very difficult to dispose of the plastic. So you have to give the answer these 6 questions.
Now class, what is your homework? Your homework is on the page number 43, exercise C, activity. You have to do this activity. So class, I hope you understand the lecture and homework also. We will meet soon, inshallah ta'ala. Till then, Allah Hafiz and take care.